So what is it that we need to actually go ahead and start place and route? So first of all, we need the design. What is the design? The design is the gate level netlist that we exported from synthesis. Second, we need constraints. So what are the constraints? These are the design constraints that are defined in the SDC files. And we're going to try to use the same design constraints that we used for synthesis. We're going to use them throughout the whole flow. We may have some sort of a variable that will help, like run type, that will help us differentiate what the actual SDC command will be during synthesis and during place and route. But I like to use the same file and not jump between files so I can, you know, change important things in one place and they will be kept consistent throughout our flow. Next, we need to talk about the process technology. So that is actually defined in the techlef, which is going to be one of the files that's provided by our foundry. And then we're going to have the process extraction rules, and they're going to be provided in QRC tech or cap tables. And again, they're going to be provided by the foundry, or you can also create them with other files that we get. Next, we have the library definition, and the library definitions are defined in .lib files, and they're, again, going to be provided by our standard cell library vendors, our IO file vendors, our SRAM vendors, etc. Next, we're going to have the physical data of the library, which are the lef files that are provided along with the lib files by our IP vendors. Okay, and next we're going to have the power ground definition. So we need to tell the tool what the power and the ground nets are. If we have some complex power structure, we're going to use something like a UPF or a CPF file. All of these together, the SDC files, the QRC tech and cap table, and the lib files, they are defined inside the MMMC file when we use an MMMC flow, which is what we're going to be using. So all of these together are defined inside the MMMC flow, as I went over in the lecture, and I'm going to show you in the example as well. Next, we're going to import our design. So we have a form called design import. Okay, so we can see this form over here, design import, but we usually do things inside a script. So we use command lines. And if we do it even once in such a tool, then when we press OK, the things will be written out into our innovus.command file, and then we can copy them into a script and manipulate them later on through the script. Okay, so the first thing is reading the netlist. We needed to have the design itself that is defined in the gate level netlist that we exported from synthesis. So this reads in the post layout synthesis netlist, and we would define that inside this area of netlist or by Verilog and so forth. You can actually have several files, but usually we're going to just read in one Verilog netlist. Next, we're going to do read physical. So that's defined here in a list of the lef files, which we can also select through this little button over here. But again, it usually is best to provide it through a long list of all the lef files that we need for all of the IP that we're going to use. Init ground nets and init power nets are two commands or two DBs that we need to set, which tell us the global PG net names. So we're going to call our PG nets, our power ground nets, something like VDD and GND or VCC and VSS or something like that. And so they would be defined, as you can see over here, there can be many of these global type nets. They're actually a virtual name, these global nets. I'll be discussing them in a few minutes. Okay, so if we have a complicated power management setup, as I mentioned before, we're going to need UPF and CPF files, so you can define a CPF file over here. Actually, I'm not going over the UPF or CPF flow here, but we'll actually read in the UPF later on if we want it. So next we're going to have the MMMC. So the MMMC defines a lot of things. It defines the SDCs, the QRC tech, the lib files, and so forth. They're all inside the MMMC file definition. You can create an MMMC file with a wizard over here through the create analysis configuration, or take something like the template that I provided. Again, inside our libraries file, we're going to have that probably set up for this particular design. It's not something you're really going to need to play with, except for maybe the name of your SDC file. Okay, so either we usually Cadence calls these a .view file. I just call them a .mmmc file. It sounds to me better than a .view file. So you're going to point to that through here or through the read mmmc command. Now that we've set all that up, we've populated this entire basically form or given the commands that are equivalent to what we populate in the form, then we can click OK, or that is equivalent to running the init design command, and that's going to do a lot of stuff. It's going to process all this data and prepare our design, and after that, our design is imported into Innovus, and we can start our run. So now we can go on to our init design stage, and we do some, you know, cleanup type of stuff, so it prints out the time and so forth. And the first two things we're going to do is set the init ground nets and init power nets. So this is a list of all of our nets that are going to be defined as global ground and power nets. Okay, so if I look at what we have over here, I could look inside the debug file or just do puts, you know, design all ground nets and puts design all power nets. And we see that in my defines file, I defined these as grounded VDD, and those are going to be the name of what we call the global nets. So our global ground and power will be GND and VDD. We can, of course, have many more of these power and ground nets in our design, but since we're at a very simple design, that's all we have. Okay, and then we're going to suppress some messages just because they bothered me when I was running this. Different things that happen for various reasons will spit out a lot of warnings, and I try to get rid of them to clean up my log file, but first times you run these things, you should really look and read all of those warnings and try to check what they are before suppressing them. Okay, then we're going to read the MMMC file, and our MMMC file we looked at before in our synthesis run, so I'm not going to go over it right now, but we have a whole setup for what our worst case and our best case and our typical case and what our selected analysis views are and so forth are over here. So we're going to read that in now. And we see that now the tool goes and reads the different libraries and sets up our MMMC flow, sets up our timing. We still haven't initialized the design, so we shouldn't really look at what's going on inside our design hierarchy, inside our database, but there is quite a lot of information already after we read our MMC file before we got to this line over here, which is init design, which is really going to go and look at all the SDCs and look at our netlist and so forth. Okay, so again, we're suppressing some more messages over here just before reading our physical information, which is our left files. So we have a variable here that's called tech files all lefts. It's going to have a list of all the left files of the tech left, the standard cells, the IOs, the memories, every type of thing that we have in our, any type of macro that we have, any type of thing that has to have some sort of physical information, we have it inside this tech files all lefts. So we are going to read it in with this read physical command. So it read in the different lefts, and again, depending on what you're actually doing, there may be a long list of macros over here. This is a very simple design. All it has is standard cells and the tech left, nothing else besides that. Now we're ready to read in the netlist. Again, we are not reading in RTL. Remember, we read in RTL at the synthesis stage. Now we already have a netlist. And so we wrote this out in under design post synthesis netlist. This is where we set up our post synthesis netlist. So we run read netlist. It will read in the netlist of our entire design. Okay, so it reads in our netlist. It parses it and so forth. It says there are different, in the end, there are 47 standard cell instances inside this design. Okay, and now basically what we did is we set up everything that is needed to start Innovus. We have the MMMC, which also defines our SDC files and our extraction files and so forth and so on. We have our lefts, all of our physical abstracts of all of the macros that we bring in. By the way, the MMC also sets up all the libs of all the macros and so forth. And we read in the netlist that came out of synthesis. So now we have this very, very large command called initDesign, which is going to go and put everything together and build one database that we're going to be using throughout our design. So we'll take this initDesign command, similar to the one we ran in Genus, but here really it does a lot more work usually. Okay, so the initDesign command could run a very long time if we had a large design. We just have a tiny little design, and that's why it doesn't take very long. But the initDesign passed, and we don't see anything that is very strange in that. So now I actually have the settings file put after here. There are a lot of different commands inside the settings file, and some of them needed design information in order to run. That's just how kind of Innovus is set up, what can be run before we've actually read in our libraries and what isn't. So I have this settings file, which sets some basic settings. You can go through the different settings that I've set. Again, this will have to be kind of configured for your standard cell library, your technology, and your preferences. Okay, so this is just all kinds of settings that I put as defaults and so forth inside my design, and maybe some of them we'll run into later on in the flow, what we are actually set over here. And the next thing is to set up those reg to reg and interreg and so forth, what we call cost groups or path groups. So they are separating different sets or groups of paths. So we look at them separately. They're reported separately. They're optimized separately and so forth. Reg to reg, interreg, reg to out, and so forth. And it's encapsulated inside one of the procedures that we wrote inside our procedures.tickle, which is called EnICS default cost groups.